Hello everyone! Welcome, it's me, Nintendo LP or Z-Dude, and I'm here with the next episode of my Let's Play of The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild. In the previous episode, we made it off the Great Plateau, and began making our... got a horse, made it to a stable, and made our way to Kakariko Village. In this episode, we are going to be heading to see Impa and see what we have to do from there. So, head on, alright. Seems to be two guys guarding her where we would have to go, so let's go down. Huh? What? You there! Who are you? How dare you trespass upon Lady Impa's abode? Hmm? Is that a Sheikah slate? But that would mean you are... No, it's not possible. Can it be? Please forgive us for behaving so rudely. Of course, we have heard the legends from Lady Impa herself. Please, friend, go ahead and step inside. Alright, just by talking to them, you can step inside of the, her abode. When you do that, Paya will be outside.
Oh, man! Is that... It's... A Sheikah Slate! Could you be the hero my grandmother told me about? What was his name? Oh, it's not that I forgot. I'm just bad with speaking. As for me, my name is my name is Paya. Phew, I got it out. I know I should be able to say that easily, seeing as how it's my own name and all. I'm so sorry. Anyway, my grandmother's been awaiting your return ever since I was little. Please hurry inside.
So, you want to open up the door, and there we go. I'll be quiet now.
So, you're finally awake. It has been quite a long time, Link. I am much older now, but you remember me, don't you?
I know there was a short break in the commentary, but here we are again.
What is the matter? You're looking at me as though I am a stranger to you. Those eyes, they lack the light of familiarity. It is I, courageous one, Impa. Surely you must at least remember the name Impa.
Oh,
I see. So you have lost your memory! Well, it matters not. In fact, that may actually be a blessing in disguise for the time being. Dearest Link, please come a bit closer.
Oh.
100 years ago. Yes, 100 years ago, the Kingdom of Hyrule was destroyed. After you fell, Princess Zelda's final wish was to place you in a sacred slumber. And then, all alone she went to face Ganon. Before Princess Zelda went to nobly meet her fate, she entrusted me with some words she wished to say to you. I have been waiting 100 years to deliver the princess's message. However, these words which the princess risked her life to leave you. Well, if you are to hear them, you must be prepared to risk your life as well. But I am afraid that burden may be too much to bear while you are still without your memories. I leave the choice to you. When you feel you are ready to receive the princess's message, return to me. The words that the princess risked her life to impart to you, I cannot pass them on to someone who lacks conviction. Are you prepared to risk your life for the greater good?
I am.
Ha! Not a memory to your name, yet you are as intent as ever to charge forward with only courage and justice on your side. You have not changed a bit. Once a hero, always a hero.
Yeah.
Very well. Since you have lost your memory, I will recount for you all that has happened.
The history of the royal family of Hyrule is also the history of Calamity Ganon, a primal evil that has endured over the ages. This evil has been turned back time and time again by a warrior wielding the soul of a hero and a princess who carries the blood of the goddess. With the passage of time, each conflict with Ganon faded into legend. So listen closely as I tell you of this legend that occurred 10,000 years ago. Hyrule was then blossoming as a highly advanced civilization. Even the most powerful monsters posed little threat to the denizens of the realm. The people thought it wise to utilize their technological prowess to ensure the safety of the land should Calamity Ganon ever return. They constructed four mechanical wonders that came to be known as the Divine Beasts. They also built a legion of autonomous weapons called Guardians. The Divine Beasts were piloted by four individuals of exceptional skill from across the land. And thus, the plan to neutralize Ganon was forged. Upon Ganon's inevitable return to Hyrule, the princess and the hero fought alongside these four champions against this ancient evil. The Guardians were tasked with protecting the hero as the Divine Beasts unleashed a furious attack upon their terrible foe. And when the hero, wielding the sword that seals the darkness, delivered his final blow, the princess used her sacred power to seal away Calamity Ganon.
Years ago, in preparation for the foretold revival of Ganon, we strove to follow the lead of our ancestors of 10,000 years prior. But in the end, despite our best efforts and careful planning, we underestimated his power. In order to avoid ever making that grave mistake again, the princess left you these words. Free the four divine beasts! That is what she said! The Divine Beasts are the ancient Shikai weapons wielded by the four champions who Ganon defeated. The Divine Beast Varudania, controlled by Daruk of the Guardians. The Divine Beast Vameto, controlled by Revali of the Rito. The Divine Beast Varuda, controlled by Mipha of the Zora. And the Divine Beast Vanaboris, controlled by Yerbosa of the Gerudo. It'd be extremely ill-advised to face Ganon without the power of the Divine Beasts to help you. You must infiltrate the Divine Beasts that were stolen away by Ganon 100 years ago and bring them back to our side. More information about these Divine Beasts can be found by locating the four races scattered across Hyrule. The Shikai Slate will guide you on your way. You must go where it tells you and meet with each leader there.
Alright, so we got a new objective.
It seems to me that your Shikai Slate is not yet complete. The device Princess Zelda left you is your guide and also your memory. Now let's see. Someone at the research lab in Ateno Village might be able to help you. You are Princess Zelda's only hope, and Hyrule's as well. You cannot turn back now! Follow your heart and seize your destiny!
Alright, if you want to change which one it has, and I believe I showed this a bit, you could actually just press A here, and there you go. We are actually going to go towards the Lock Mementos right now, and, my bad. Didn't mean to talk to her at that point. So, we're going to make our way to Hateno Village, and yeah, so, if you notice in the last episode, and I know I did a voiceover, post-commentary, actually, we are going to make our way to Hateno. If you go in there, you could actually get some good gear for stealth and whatnot. I'm not going to go out of my way to get them right now. So we're just going to head out of this village right now. We will be returning to Kakariko every so often. It's not like a main hub town or anything. There's really no main hub besides Hyrule Field, but even that isn't really a hub in a sense. In the sense of the word, so yeah, there we go. So, we are going to continue on. Let's begin galloping down. Because I want to unlock those memories. And as you can see, Hateno is in a darkened area. So, we're going to go after another tower on our way there. I know precisely where the tower is, how to climb it, and whatnot. There are members of the Yuga clan. You'll be seeing them out and about disguised as travelers. Until you beat their leader, they will only be disguised as travelers, easy to avoid. Which I guess is a good thing. Anyways, there's Hestu. That one guy that the Koroks were telling you about. So, let's go here, jump off, get off our horse. And let's talk to him.
Shalaka? You! You can see me?
I can't see you.
Shaloko? Then how are you talking to me, silly boy? Shalaka! It's been 100 years since anyone has been able to see me. I'm Hestu, and I need your help. Those monsters over there stole my beloved maracas. I think they're still there on the other side of those rocks. I can't use my powers without them, Shoko. So please, please get my maracas back from them.
Alright, so this is a side quest. We need to get their priceless maracas side quest complete. Because there's something I want to talk about that regards Hestu. Something that a lot of people find frustrating. So, yeah, let's, so to get his maracas back, you actually have to defeat these bokoblins here. Where is it? I don't want to die right now, so I'm actually going to eat one of my meals. There we go. And let's go with the sword. Wait. There we go. And yes, if you're going to do a flurry rush and you're dodging an attack, as long as it's perfectly timed, it doesn't matter who you're locked on to, by the way. There we go. You know what? Let's go with the Traveler's Spear because it has a good reach. We could actually keep... Man, there's some frame rate drops right there. Jesus. He fell. There we go, and he fell. Now, I believe I should do it, right? Yeah, I mean, they both should be... There we go. Just beginning to wonder what the hell. Did they survive? But no, they're dead. Okay, there we go. So just by killing them, you get to open up this chest, and within it is the Hetsu's maracas! You got the item! You got the thing! Probably off-key, because I can't really hear the game at this point. But I would suggest collecting the Boko Shield, the Boko Club, and there's the Boko Spear, which isn't all that good, so I'm not going to collect it at right now. But we're going to switch over to the club right now and make our way back to Hetsu because we got his priceless maracas. And you might be noticing I did avoid a shrine. We have no spirit orbs. And yes, it's going to be 4 spirit orbs for an upgrade. So, you know, we'll have to complete 4 shrines to get any upgrades. Shalaka! But wait, there's something wrong with my maracas. Korok seeds and side are gone. How am I supposed to dance now, Shoko? If only I had 1 Korok seed, I could sing, dance, and use my powers to help you. You see, I have the power of inventory expansion. So let me know if you find some Korok seeds. So, you know, we have Korok seeds. Yes, please. We give it to him, and he can upgrade our weapon stash, the bow stash, or the shield stash. I'm going to show this one time, and that'll be it. I will be showing you where to find him from time to time during your adventure, because he will be, after this location and you get his maracas back, he will be moving forward closer to the Korok Forest until you make it there, and then he'll be there permanently. So, yeah, there you go. So we completed the side quest of priceless maracas and got an extra slot in our weapon inventory. Now, you might be wondering, oh, but you have 1 more Korok seed. Why don't you go and upgrade it again? I could, but I'm going to wait till I have 2, then upgrade the bow and the shield stash because I could, because I want to go that way, weapon, bow, shield, weapon, bow, shield. And each time it won't be 1 Korok seed, it'll go up by 1 each time. So the next time I want to upgrade the weapon stash, it'll be 2 Korok seeds. After that, it'll be 3. Then after that, it'll be 4, and so on and so forth. And same thing goes for the bow and the shield stash as well. So, yeah, and I believe in total with the Korok seeds, you need 461, I believe, somewhere in that ballpark. Either 441, 441 or 461 seeds to fully max out your inventory slots, you know, your weapon, shield, and bow slots completely. And there's 900 in total. I'm not going to go out after all 900. This ain't a 100% run. I don't want to go that nuts. I don't want to be like, okay. Feed all the divine beasts. Now where are the rest of... And I got all 120 shrines. Now where are the rest of the Korok seeds? I don't want to go like that. You know, I don't want to kill myself over that and whatnot. So, you know, you could probably find a guide online at some point. Probably not right now because the game's just a month old and I don't want to have people seem like they're that nuts. I mean, there is a few people out there that have found all 900 right now, so. I mean, I could be wrong. There could be an entire guide right now. But then again, those people probably used a Prima guide or something to help them out. So, not anything I have because I want to leave this game to my own imagination and whatnot. So, yeah, here we go. We're going through this area. We're making our way through Fort Hateno right now. And as you can see, we're no longer in an area that we know that we have activated the tower to get the information for. But if you look around, I believe, you can see the tower in the distance. No. Okay. You can see there in the distance, there's Hateno Village, so we're actually quite close to there. Quite close, yeah, still far away. We're not exactly there yet. There's a traveler, a Yuga clan member there. They spawn in various areas. There's a merchant there that you could talk to if you need anything. I think he sells bugs. You know, quite good at making stuff like that. We're going to go activate a tower right now. There's a shrine that you can see in the distance in the middle of the town. Each town will have a shrine near it. Same thing with each of the stables. Now, you may notice I did not activate a shrine for that stable or this stable or even the shrine for Kakariko Village. It's mainly because I'm going to save those for some time soon because I want to make a video where I go about activating all 120 and tell you about where they are. So, you know, and that will be in the middle of this Let's Play. I'm going to go about activating all the towers right now since it's a little hard for me to go about making a video like that without detailing where each of these shrines were without having the towers active. So, yeah. So, from time to time during my Let's Play, you will see that, but I will be mainly skipping shrines for now until I activate all the towers. So, it'll begin hard, but it'll get easier for me. I will not be going after the Divine Beasts until I have gotten at least two more hearts. Two more hearts and one more stamina upgrade. So, yeah. Now, I'm going to go after the Hateno Tower, and we're near Hateno Village right now. So, if you look the distance, there's the tower that we need to get to. So, you might be wondering, oh, how do you get to that tower? It's a little far away. Well, there's a wooded area here. If you trek across here on horseback or on foot, sorry, Lily, didn't mean to do that. Oh yeah, and by the way, if you are still in Kakariko Village while you're watching this video or anything, or you want a nice tip, you can go to Kakariko Village, buy a carrot, and feed it to your horse. It won't max out your friendship or bond with your horse, but it will give you a nice boost, because the favorite fruit for horses in this game, or vegetable rather, is carrots. So feed them a carrot every now and then, and it'll help. And if you get a swift carrot and feed it to them, they will actually get some bonuses for that. So yeah. So let's go this way. At this point, it's just as simple as following the path ahead and whatnot. There will be a few moblins up ahead as well, so on. Goblin and a goblin right there. Alright, so what you want to do here is follow this path up, and there will be those things here. You can burn them to make your life a hell of a lot easier. So let's grab our fire arrows. Bomb arrows will not burn anything, so yeah, there you go. And just by watching that, and a nice little tip. Ouch. Thought that would have burned as well, huh? Alright, there we go. Took some damage there, but not bad. Not bad at all. So as you can see there, I made it to Hateno Tower. It's registered. Ouchies. I need food. There we go. Ragdoll physics really suck in a lot of games. There we go. And yeah. A little trick here to get to. Oh, damn it. Didn't make it. Fucking. Excuse that language. I did not mean to swear. I just am a little frustrated with this because lack of hearts, and I'm taking way more damage than I wanted to for this. Damn it. Lack of stamina is bad stamina. Come on. Climb up. Go up. Get on late. Damn it, Boko Bro, Bo broke. Okay, I have two. There. Okay. Take out our. That should help, okay. I'll do a speed up right here because I don't want you guys to be watching me fail constantly and having to worry about commentary as well. So, I'll see you guys when I'm up. After I've activated the tower, oh. Thank you. is quite good.
That's no good.
So as you can see down there, there's Lily. Let's use our glider. Glide. Jump down pretty fast, actually. And let's go down forward to her and make our way to Hatena right now. Alright, and as you can see here on the map, we now have the path layout. That one was actually funny. Come on, Lily. Turn around. There we go. Now let's begin galloping down. They are asleep. You could actually perform a sneak strike, which will, more often than not, one-hit the enemies, but not all the time. Depends on your weapon. Like, if you use a tree branch against a sleeping bokoblin, it wouldn't do much against them. So, yeah, there we go. So now we have a pathway that we can follow towards it. You know, the way I took was an out-of-the-way way close to the village, but, you know, let's continue on to Hatena and meet with that. And once we enter, I'll end the video because, you know, don't want them to be too long. 30-minute episodes is quite long, I understand that. So, you know, I'll do what I can, speed through what I can, you know, like climbing the towers. I won't be doing all of them in slow mode. It'll depend on difficulty of the tower. That one is quite simple, but is quite hard if you don't have the right weapon. And I will be going about talking about how to revive your horse at some point and whatnot. I'm not going to go help out those people yet, because again, I just want to get through this. So here we go. It's the entrance to a town, to a village, actually. It's Hatena Village. And so from here, there's a shrine there, which you can see there. They all act as fast travel points. Since we have the map done, I'll talk about another way you can go about getting the Warm Doublet. Okay? Now, for whatever reason, if you sell your Warm Doublet, like if you're low on rupees or whatnot, let's get off the horse. Here's a clothing store, not a general store, clothing store. And here, as you'll see in the back, they actually stock Warm Doublet. It's 80 rupees for one, but isn't that bad if you actually go mining? There's some of those there. And a full Hylian set. Hylian trousers, a Hylian hood, and a Hylian tunic. Not that bad. I'm not going to go out buying any right now. And so, in the next episode of my Breath of the Wild, let's play of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, I will be making my way up to meet with that old... with that person that Impa wanted me to meet with in the ancient tech lab. And we will be furthering exploring this village, because I don't want to just go about entering and exiting every village all that quickly. So in the next episode, it'll be that way. We'll make our way there. So I'll see you guys then. This has been Nintendo LPRZ Dude, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye, guys. Just so I can end it here. Next episode will be abridged. Yeah, I'll go kill myself.